No.
How many fingers am I holding up?
Three, Ma.
Baby, your eyes are closed.
Ma, you always hold up three fingers.
Okay, how many fingers am I holding up now?
Ma, please.
Who exercises wearing a big ring?
Mafioso.
I am sorry.
You punched the money.
Oh, thanks, Ma.
Baby, I'm sorry. You know what I mean.
Man, we gotta get Cam to the hospital. Last time I seen an eye like that, it was in my hand.
Okay, no hospitals. We gotta keep this as private as possible.
Like Mafioso.
I'm gonna call the team doctor. You two best get your story straight.
That was a look at the hit series on Starz, Survivor's Remorse. Joining us now, the show's EP, executive producer, and creator from Nashua, New Hampshire, Bishop Girton High School, Mike O'Malley.
Hey, good to be here.
Might you guys know each other?
It's good to be here, Mike. Let's talk about the Red Sox.
Two
in a row over the Yankees. Hey, how many wild cards are there now?
They're
There's like seven. There's seven. We're still fighting for the wild card. I can't wait to get in the playoffs.
Honestly, that was the highlight of the whole show. We've been on for 2 hours. Keep going.
I'm just excited. I mean, that's what they're doing. The fans want more playoffs. Playoffs. Let's get as many teams as we can
wild
in the playoffs. More wild cards. People just want it. They just like the sport. We're just expanding the sport.
Hey, Fitzy, come on in here.
Right.
Come on in.
Let's do it.
Listen, how much fun is it doing this great series?
It's been fantastic. You know, one of the great things about working on Starz is they give you the freedom to tell stories that you can't really do on other networks and on broadcast networks. I think the last time I was here was family show that was on NBC. I loved it, loved working on it, but it didn't last. And one of the things that is great about working on Starz is that you can talk about family subject matters and take on topics that you can't in other places.
Right.
And if you do it honestly, people tune in.
And this looks pretty gritty. Tell us the premise.
The premise of the show came from Maverick Carter and LeBron James, who grew up in Akron, Ohio, and you know, now they're on top of the world. Mm-hmm. And Maverick Carter is, LeBron James is one of his good friends and business partners. And yet they left that place and now are often, you know, the highest of the highs all around the world. And there's people that they can still help back home. And this notion that when you survive, if you're somebody who survives a plane crash or a shipwreck, why did I succeed? Why did I survive? And other people perish. I think this is a thing that happens for athletes who come from a tough background and they leave their circumstances of where they grew up and they left poverty and they go and they succeed. How do they reconcile that? How do they continue
to make good choices?
Yeah, and because there's always people that they can help. There's always another person they can throw a life preserver to. There's always, you know, there's scholarships, there's money, there's people that they can help constantly, and yet they have to go on in their own world. And what's that push and pull? That's at the center of what the show's about.
And LeBron is a hands-on player in the show.
Yes, he is a great, as people saw in the movie that he did this summer, he's a great actor, and he's actually doing episode 9, which is in 3 weeks. He's fantastic. We talked to him about the stories. I'm going out to Cleveland next week to talk to him about stories for a third season. We got picked up for a third season. And so I think there's a lot of things that happen. What I like about this show is that oftentimes you see athletes, they give very polished answers to the press, and they present themselves as a you know, great version of a human being, as they should. Yet there's things that happen behind the scenes before they step in front of those cameras. I like to, you know, get into that kind of stuff.
Well, that gets to the question I was going to ask you. I mean, LeBron James is, as Mike said, hands-on in this, but how much did you know yourself about the life of an NBA star behind the scenes?
Well, I was cut from the freshman basketball team in 1981 in Bishop Girton High School, so I don't know that much about freshman basketball. But I'm more interested in actually the human part of it. You know, the do and the don't, the right and the wrong. What is the issues that we can talk about, what I think is relatable about it? Because money, as we know, it changes people. This is a show where the character is trying not to be somebody who ends up on a documentary about how did he lose all of his money. And he's a very caring guy. He's a very thoughtful guy. And so there's a lot of not angst, but there's a lot of thought going into how can he be a transformative figure. Look at a guy like LeBron James, who's just committed, you know, $80 million, I believe it is, to sending kids to college. Mm-hmm. Talk about dropping the mic and, you know, saying to other athletes, can you step up and do the same thing? Mm-hmm. He puts his money where his mouth is. And so we're trying to write a character who's, you know, going to do something like that.
Mm-hmm. And you, sir, are a transformative figure as well. Survivor's Remorse airs Saturday nights at 9:30 on Starz. It is a great series. It really is good. Mike O'Malley, thanks very much. Up next, what, if anything, did we learn today other than a wildcat?